Hi all, welcome to John's Model Making. Today we've got Knight Rider issue 7. Excellent stuff. Let's have a quick look at the instructions. So stage 7, in this issue you receive the parts for the steering gearbox. You will fix the gearbox onto the front left chassis beam and mount the upper suspension control arm on the left side of the front axle crossmember. Excellent stuff. There we go, we got 1, 2, 3, 8 steps. Step 8. Again. Well, we'll see how we get on with that one. And then here we have the result. This picture shows the steering gearbox fixed onto the front left chassis beam and the front left suspension upper control arm mounted on the front axle crossmember. Excellent stuff. Well, without any further ado, let's get on with the build. Here are the parts, let's get them out. Okay, no, those are the parts. Front left chassis beam, steering column, steering gearbox top, steering gearbox bottom, steering cross joint times 2, steering gear 1 and 2, front left suspension, upper control arm, and 4 sets of screws, all for metal, EMGM, IM and MM. Okay, let's put these to one side. Let's get out what we need straight away. What we do need are the GM screws, these two pieces. This is a steering cross joint between the two flanges of the steering gear. I don't know whether it goes, does it match? I think they're exactly the same no matter which way I put this one on. Let's find out. These screws seem pretty long as well, but it's going in nicely. There we go. There we go, secure the parts. That is secure. It won't move. Excellent stuff. Now we need this piece, which goes there. Again, two GM screws, one there and one underneath. Excellent stuff. That moves around a little bit. Just unloosen this one a little bit. See if this one, yeah, should be fine. There we go. Excellent. As I'm aware, that is correct. Brilliant stuff. Okay, next up we need to put the cross joint on the end of this steering gear, another GM screw. There we go. Excellent, that's the one on the other end. Okay, now what we need is 7D, which is this, I believe. That goes there, like so. Yep. That pops down there, like that. And we capture all that in place with that top there. Excellent. And we need EM screws, three of. Let's put the first one in. There we go. That's how that should look. Brilliant. Now we need to put this, two holes there. It goes in there like that. Yep. And we need 2 mm screws. These are flange screws. Excellent stuff. There we go. That looks brilliant. And from underneath, we need to fit an EM screw just here. There we go. That's that in place. Excellent stuff. Alright, we can pop that to one side, because now we need to fit this there with two IM screws, just like we did with this side. Okie doke. Lesson learned from last time, let's see if we can tap this screw through first. It should make it a lot easier. That's that through. Let's take it out. Got a thread there now. We'll pop this piece in place. Can actually see the hole. There we go, that's the first one through. This one should line up. No problem. But will it? There we go. Should be coming through nicely. There we go. Excellent. Pretty fiddly, them two screws, but that is it. That is issue 7 complete. There we go, brilliant stuff. Oops, let me move that camera. There we go. That's moving nicely. And those two pieces are on that crossmember. Brilliant. Well, there we go, guys. That's issue 7 done. That's that crossmember, axle crossmember, and there we are, that chassis beam with that steering gear in place. Excellent stuff. This side, yes, this side, what I've just put on, a lot quicker than that, because you learn, don't you, how to put them on. That was difficult on the last one, but just tapping the screw in, putting some oil on it as always, and it made it a lot easier tapping the screw through the first time, well, before putting that piece on. But anyway, that is it. That is excellent. So I've got 8, 9 and 10 to put up on the channel yet. I'll get around to them as soon as possible, but it's looking brilliant, this. Absolutely loving this build. Oh yes, before I finish off, I gave my head a bit of a wobble the other day, because I keep calling them fog lights headlights. Don't know where I'm getting that from, but you see your lights, I call it a headlight, but they're all them three fog lights. And like I said in the last issue, I've ordered the grills off Mike Lane, so they should look superb. I know I've seen cars without the grills, but I think they'll look really snazzy once I put them in place. But anyway, thanks for watching. If you did like that, subscribe, hit that notification bell, give us a big thumbs up, and I'll see you soon for issue 8 of KITT Knight Rider, the beautiful car. Anyway, I'm going on too much now. Thanks for watching. Stay safe. Bye for now.